Dear twin flame souls out there, welcome to the Twin Flame Awakening Podcast, and today is in episode number 38, where we are going to discuss about how do you get your twin flame coming back to you. After a short break, as many of you noticed that there hasn't been many episodes coming out, there was a super moon that was super intense, and I'm really apologizing that I didn't comfort you through that. But the super moon took me closer to the God, to the universe, that I got really, really sick. And the fever, I haven't had fever for a very long time. But since the universe felt that I need rest, which I haven't taken for myself, I took this as a sign from the universe that it's time to pause. So I apologize for every one of you who were waiting for my podcast to come out. Well, today we are here, and today's episode is very special for the fact that I'm going to give you the blueprint of how to get your twin flame coming back to you. This blueprint is something I would call today a little bit like a workshop. So take your time, even a pen and a pencil, to discover something you might haven't done yet. Those who have booked the call with me and had consultations, they most probably have done it, so for them it's more familiar. Those who haven't yet, so here is your chance to do this on your own and realize how much closer you will get to your twin flame. These steps are pretty much from my side of the how did I get my twin flame coming back to me, and also how my clients, my souls, have now reunited with the twin flames and what has happened and why. I remember just another day when I was sick here, and I was just thinking about it, like I keep on telling to everyone how important it is to become your higher self and serve the world in your highest power and the frequency. While I know that you don't want to hear that, because all you can think of is how to get your twin flame coming back to you, that you need your twin flame. You don't need to become your higher self. You need this love, you need this connection, you need this what you had together. And I can totally relate to this, because when I was in my dark night of the soul and I had no idea that it would lead me up where I am today, all I could think of is how to get my twin flame back. But also it was difficult for me to accept that I need to do the work. I need to do the energy shift. We spoke about the energy shift just on my recent Patreon call as well. As I was sick, I was not unable to edit it. Now it should be up on Patreon. So for those who would like to hear about the energy shift, ayahuasca, and divine masculine who woke up and shared her story, why did she run? It's all up there. You can listen to this over there and get an overview. I speak about this at the end of today's podcast in more detail. And I know that if somebody would have told me that all you have to do is go within, follow your heart, trust the journey, and do what you're supposed to do, and your twin flame comes back to you even stronger than ever before, I don't think that would have been advice I would want to hear or listen or do. That is also some of the things I feel with some of the souls I have a call with, and when I tell them you have to do this, there is no other way, they don't really want to do it. And again, how do I say, it's not that, and that's why from now on there is no more free consultation for the fact. It's the first call is discounted. But it's just for the fact that I would like to know that if you have a call with me, that you will really surrender into that journey and do what I'm asking you to do. Because energy healing, energy is very important. And it's not something we should take it like, oh yes, great story, but I'm gonna continue doing what I'm doing. Twin flames are here for a mission, are here for something to do big. And also I want to say that when I was going through the twin flames And I was looking, watching tarot readings, which was very comforting. And again, I'm going to say, you can watch tarot readings. You can feel this, that makes you feel good. This is all good. But also, you need to start letting go of the energies. That's why becoming a high frequency soul, the soul that's going to attract, not the soul that needs, the soul who's going to attract, the soul who is going to create its own reality. That's why I'm talking highly about why you need to shift your energy. And that's where it all starts. If it's not going to be on this way, I don't have much of the hope that you will come together with your twin flame. And I'm going to explain everything in detail today. So feel free to sit, relax, take a pen, take a paper, and just see what is going to happen after this podcast. So the number one thing is, and it's actually one of the hardest thing, is that you become clear about the fact that you are now on a twin flame journey. You had your spiritual awakening. You have your connection with your higher self, with the universe, with the God, with the tree, with the, I don't know, bird. Anyone can call their version of God the way they feel. But we need to address it, that there is a higher power. And meeting your twin flame was a big sign of that, that you felt something so divine, something so beautiful, where no longer the time and space made sense to you, where you were lost in the moment, but it was such a beautiful moment. It was a moment where you became alive. You never loved the way you did. You never felt this electricity in your body. You never felt this energy of being alive and enjoying everything that what the life is going to give you. You needed no sleep. You needed no food. There was just all about this energy. And this energy that was so unreal for you when you first came across with it. So now your logical mind, after, let's say, your twin flame ran away, or you are in a separation, or your twin flame did something, is very difficult to accept. Because we normally, humans, when we haven't come across with our twin flame, the crush or the feeling will fade at one point. It will start to go away. It will be there for, let's say, a month or two, but then eventually it will just start to fade. Maybe there is a half a year crush. But with twin flames, you simply can't get them out of your mind. The moment you wake up, the moment you go to sleep, the moment you do something, and they are always there. Here is another thing which I can tell is somehow I wouldn't recommend, is that where you're trying to deny the connection. So you're starting to say, no, you know, I let go of this twin flame, is never coming back to me. We are not together. This is not real. How do I get my twin flame out of my head? I start to distract myself with things. I start to do other things. I just need to get him or her out of my head. So I will rather do other things than focusing on this. Well, here I'm about to say to you that the universe will not leave you alone, because you have now this energy. You have that love energy inside of you. So the more you're denying, the harder your awakening is going to be. So here you're asking me now, so what I'm supposed to do? You just need to tell the universe, all right, universe, I know I'm on this journey. I know I am part of the twin flame. I know I met part of my soul. And I also know that it's for my higher good. I'm here and I am thankful that I met my twin flame. I know I am on this twin flame. And here is just about to say that your brain will definitely start, but how come? How come he's your twin flame? How come is this? So you will have a lot of doubt. And every time when things don't go the way you want them to go, you're like, no, it's not a twin flame connection. This is not real. This is not true. I don't believe in that. And so on and so on. Well, the more you're letting your mind to abuse you, the more you are going to suffer. The faster you will say, okay, fine. I met my twin flame. I've never experienced something like this in my life. I don't know what it is, but I know I met my twin flame because I have this weird sense of knowing that I met my twin flame. I don't know why, how, but I know. And I cannot explain this. I simply cannot. Here is why when I am working with you or we are going step by step, sometimes it's hard to hear what I'm going to tell you because you are not yet there, and it sounds a little bit like, well, you have no proof. Like, okay, great story, but how? And for me, it's pretty much every single time. It's like when I'm talking and I'm like, how do I know if I don't have a proof? How do I feel? How do I see these things? I don't know, but I just know. And I can't show it today. I believe that it's just a matter of time where our energies will be visible, our energy, like we understand the importance of the frequencies, we'll understand the love energy, the fear energy, like we can see it and we can do something about it. We're still a little behind with our science, but I don't believe that we're going to stay there. Now, if you would ask me, like, one of the reasons is when you will accept that you are on this twin flame journey, your twin flame will start accepting it as well. Now I'll be like, no, that doesn't make any sense, because if I focus on my twin flame runs away. Wow, here you are not focusing on your twin flame. You're focusing on this connection. You're realizing I, as a soul, I am twin flame. I am the twin flame. It's not your twin flame who ran away, it's you. So you're realizing yourself, your soul self, who you are. So that's why your twin flame starts to realizing. Often, when it happens, and it happened to me, when I finally surrendered into the God, into the universe, whatever we want to call it, I surrendered and I said, okay, fine. You want me to be a part of this twin flame journey? Let me be part of this twin flame journey. It was still hard for my mind to accept. But then, back then, I was listening to the All-Star World by Kurt. And that's why I can say why I'm telling that we don't like hearing becoming our higher self and energy shift and all of that. But the truth is what will help you get there. Not the beautiful stories, how, you know, just do nothing and your twin flame comes back, or just block them and they come back. I simply, seeing of my own journey and my client's journey, I'm like, no, it's not going to happen this way. And now I can also explain why it has taken me time to realize that. But I realized everything is vibration, everything is energy. And when our energy is blocked, when our energy is living in fear, it will simply not happen. So now you accepted that you're part of the twin flame journey. You literally say it out loud. I am the twin flame. I'm part of this journey. I accept that. I finally accept that, and I will no longer doubt that. Believe me, you will start seeing 1111 a lot less than you're used to. 1111 will be always part of there. When you need, let's say, reassurance from the universe that you are now awakened and you are on your spiritual journey, and the gate and the portal is open for you. But this 1111 will not be like a bad dream all the time, that you cannot do anything and you only see 1111. The next thing is that you need to start shifting your energy. And that's one of the hardest part. That's why when you need now the consultation call, or you need to start getting yourself closer to your twin flame, Here is the number one thing. You need to identify your fears. Because you have fear of losing your twin flame. You feel you're not good enough for your twin flame. You feel that connection was way too good and you don't understand why did you feel this way.
And you will also have a lot of fears, like that you don't even know that you have it inside of you, but you have all of them. Oh my. So now you'll be asking me, like, why is that so important? Why is it so important for me to discover my fears, discover my insecurities, sit with this pain and say that this is who I am and this is what I have to let go of? Because that's the old self of mine. There's another thing that is also very important to notice. The moment you met your twin flame, you are no longer the same person. You're simply not the same person. Many of you who are listening to my podcast have noticed that I never say my name. And I have a reason actually for that. Because the name that I was given, and I love my name, I absolutely do, was the name I knew myself before meeting my twin flame. The person, the ego, the persona I was with this name. When I met my twin flame and I experienced something so divine, so beautiful, something that I never experienced in my life before, and when I was about to start my podcast and all of that, I just felt, I don't know who is this old me by the name. Yes, I know who she is prior. I know her very well. But she is no longer the same person. I don't have a new name in that terms. I haven't yet found it from the universe, or the universe hasn't given me yet that this should be the twin flame, this spiritual awakening, like awakened persona name. And I kind of also like to be the humble of the fact that the less I have things around my ego, the less I have things to identify myself with, the better I feel, because I'm feeling I am constantly learning, I am serving the world by helping others to wake up, by helping others to come to union with their twin flame and serve the world in their highest good. I also would like to say that I had another time a comment here where person was saying, yeah, you don't always lose the job and all of that, because we need also people, let's say, who are doctors or lawyers or anybody, or I don't know in which field, that they'll be awakened and they will also help with this. And I totally agree. It doesn't always mean that you are going to lose your job when you have a spiritual awakening, but it happens often because we have chosen not to serve our highest good. For example, let's say if you happen to be a doctor and now you can heal people and serve people with the energy, with an understanding that not everything is by the books, but you're realizing there is so much more that can help a human, then there is a big difference, because we know that we have systems in place that are no longer making sense. And if you are part of that system and you can make a change after meeting your twin flame, then you are a true gift. You are what we need in this world. So serve it in your highest good, in your highest purpose. So let's go back to this number second, which is, I think it's going to take some time. So take your time also today to realize why you need to sit down with your fears. Fear is a low vibrational energy. Fear is the one that keeps us in a box that we will not listen to our intuition, we will attract low vibrational situations. And the moment where we don't actually follow our path, we don't follow what we're supposed to do. We can see with the fear that fear is constantly, we see it on TV, news, like pretty much what people talk about it is often fear. We saw the fear through the pandemic what we had. And fear is something that holds us back to be ourselves. Because when we fear the danger, when we fear that something bad can happen, we're very afraid of making the next step. But in twin flame journey, if you don't take the next step, your twin flame is not coming back to you as quickly as well. And I had another day when we had a call on our Patreon where the divine masculine was talking why she was running away from her divine feminine, why she found all the excuses, why she found it very logical and all of that. And then I found another interesting fact that when she said she started to wake up and all of that, and now she's divine feminine, although she's both, she's actually both now. And there I found that something very interesting, that even though we divine feminines want our divine masculine to wake up, until we do not accept that we are on this journey, like we need to accept that as well. You know, you know now that you are on the journey. You Google, you listen to my podcast, you are searching the information. You know that you are on this journey. But how much do you believe that you are really on this journey, that you're finally saying, all right, I met my twin flame. I really met my twin flame who changed me and my life forever. I'm no longer the same person. But now, if you're not no longer the same person, you can't also have this old ego self, low vibrational energies, fear of not having love, fear of being alone, fear of abandonment, fear of communication, fear of not being you, fear of not talking out, fear of speaking out, fear of not doing what you love doing, fear of judgment, fear of losing everything what you have. I like to call that in this journey you have to become naked. And naked not that I take off your clothes, but naked in the sense that you are so vulnerable. Because when we are naked, we are vulnerable. We know that. Well, although, yes, we seem to see more and more naked part on social media, but that's a sad part somehow, because they are actually very vulnerable. Anyways, long story short, we're not going too much into the psychology, more of the energy. When I remove everything from you, I remove your title of the job, I remove your clothes, I remove your family, I remove your everything, I remove from you, you become naked. How will you feel? How will you feel if you should stand in front of me today naked and tell me about yourself? Would you feel comfortable? Would you feel like that something has been taken away from you? Do you feel the loss? Do you feel that this is uncomfortable, this is not you, this is so old, so new, I don't want to do this, this is not something I am part of? So here is something what twin flame separation does to us. It makes us very vulnerable, and it makes us to look into the mirror, in that terms, naked. Where we're realizing that everything that we have put around ourselves is for protection. We protect ourselves from something and somehow. which is normal. We need human instinct to protect, but we also don't need that energy. That, like, for example, you had a bad relationship 10 years ago and you are still holding this bad relationship's energy inside of you. Because if you do that, your twin flame will not come back to you, because your twin flame doesn't want to be in a bad relationship. It doesn't want to be in insecurity. It doesn't want to be in sadness, or, you know, that things will not work out and there is no magic happening. Because to me, I'm still, you can call me crazy, but I believe it's a miracle. It's a miracle that I met my twin flame. I had no idea about my twin flame until I met my twin flame. And what happened to me from that moment is something so divine, so beautiful. I've never been more connected to my soul than I am today. But it required quite a lot of work for me to get there. So I'm not going to say it's going to be a walk in the park and your twin flame just pops back. Because also your twin flame has to come to the same frequency eventually. So this is why all these steps are important. We can't just skip them and hope that it will happen. Yeah, it will happen sooner or later. But why to later if you can have it sooner? But also the knowing and the understanding of this journey is very important. Again, I'm about to say, which you don't like hearing, and I know, and I'm totally fine with that, is that twin flames are not a love story. Twin flame is your spiritual awakening that comes through the love, through a beautiful healing, and you have that love energy power now. You are the love. But when the love is fighting against your fears, your insecurities, your not seeing yourself who you are, it's very difficult to come over it. So start today. Sit down today with yourself or book a call with me and let's just discover your fears. Let's just sit with your fears. Is it the most comfortable conversation? No, not at all. And I wouldn't like talking about it. Not at all. I wouldn't like talking about it. But the moment you talk about it, the moment you analyze about it, that freedom that comes with it, the answers that will come with it are so powerful. The people I had very deep conversation on my consultations, all of them have written back to me saying, the peace, what I'm feeling now is like when I met my twin flame. I'm now finally starting to let go of all of this that has been triggering in this relationship. So, and things starts to happen. I like to bring more of my own stories than from my clients, because I still would like to keep your confidentiality. That I will, how do I say, I will not abuse your information for the podcast. Like I said, there was this supermoon, and I believe many of us felt the supermoon very strongly. It was extremely difficult for me this time, because I've been working with so many of you, and I've worked myself over. Like, I've burned myself a little bit. I know my guides were already telling me that I need to slow down. This is too much. Take it one step at a time. Supermoon happened to be an Pisces, and I'm a Pisces moon, so it was like all at the same time, and I was emotionally very fragile. I was very fragile because like I said, I've been working with so many of you, and it's been absolutely incredible. And I honestly feel after our group call last time, I felt like I'm serving a purpose, because we're getting the answers, we're getting the solutions, and so on. But as I got really sick, when we get sick, it's actually the sign from the universe to reflect and see it back, what you no longer want in your life. And instead of blaming my partner or
let's say things didn't go as planned or something, I had to sit down and start reflecting of myself. Like, why are the things like this? I must be creating something because there has to be the reality of that. So I kept on going until I got all the answers of my energy, what I've been doing wrong, and so on. Luckily, I had a friend next to me who was really helpful to discover. That's why, again, I'm about to say that it's easier when somebody else is there to hear you and discover these little doors. And why I'm talking about it is that I said certain things during this talk, like what I had. I said, I like to have my life like this, and I like to have certain things this way and that way. And I started to open up of realizing what I actually want and what energy no longer should be there. And first of all, of course, the things happened to me within less than 24 hours the way I wanted them, because I became very clear and I let go of any kind of blockage that was there. And so here is why I'm so profound of explaining: let go of your fears, let go of your insecurities, let go of every single doubt you have, and just face them, say goodbye to them, and then say, what do you actually want? And I can guarantee you it will happen extremely quickly. So now just a little exercise before I'm going to the next step is like, how are you going to identify your fears by yourself? I'm also going to tell you that this is some exercise you don't really want to do. It's not something, let's say, you're watching a funny movie or you're scrolling on social media. It's a very uncomfortable time. But without that, you will not become your higher self nor closer to your twin flame. Is that the first thing you're starting to ask yourself is like, why? Why I am thinking that my twin flame is not loving me? Why do I have that fear that my twin flame is not loving me? Because he left me or she left me. Why do I feel that my twin flame is not loving me? Is it because I've never felt the love like this? And it's hard for my mind to realize that I fell in love with someone who was not supposed to, I was not supposed to fall in love with, and I fell in love. But this love is so strong that I just simply cannot explain it, and I don't know what is happening to me. But I'm so afraid that he or she is not loving me back. So now let's go. Why you are so afraid? Why are you afraid of something good happening in your life? Why you even believe that you and your twin flame had no connection? Why? Why are you feeling this way? So keep on asking this why, and when the why keeps on giving you answers, write them down. And do this exercise over and over and over again. Whatever comes out of it, write it down. Whatever, really. It can be, let's say, you are afraid because I think he doesn't believe me, for example. Well, why do you think like that? Why? So keep on puzzling this. That's very important. It will make such a shift. If you really want to be together with your twin flame, do this and watch it happen. So number three is, and this is something that many twin flame coaches are saying, and I totally agree with that, is that let go of the idea of your twin flame. Let go of the idea what your twin flame is doing. Did your twin flame feel the energy? Let go of this idea that you need answers, such as, did my twin flame love me? Why did he run away? Why my twin flame is not coming back? why my twin flame is doing like this? Why did my twin flame start dating somebody else? Why my twin flame is not telling me what I want him to tell? This is very ego-based. You want something from someone. You always want. Well, how about you will receive, not that you want. Also, the same it goes into manifestation. When you want something, the universe is not going to give you what you want. The universe will give you what you deserve based on your energy, based on what you believe. So now, a very simple example. You want your twin flame to tell you that your twin flame loved you. Then start believing that he loved you. I know that's one of, again, a very hard thing. That's why I'm saying these exercises are not easy. They are not, you do it one time and things will start to happen. Again, I'm about to say that if you wish to have a call, book a call with me and let's start working on it. Because there are many layers before we go all the way in. But here is the thing. Many, also I've heard it. Even the one guy who I was following was saying that your twin flame don't feel any of that what you felt. I disagree here 100% based on the facts that, yes, your twin flame felt everything that you felt when you first came together. Was it scary? Of course. That energy is so scary that when you first come across, and even yourself, because right now you are in a fear state as well, because this energy was so beyond and so beautiful, and you're so afraid of losing your twin flame. So you see, there is a lot of fear because it's so powerful. This is just so powerful. It's way beyond we have ever experienced before. So you have to let go of an idea of your twin flame. You have to believe. And this is a thing. Your twin flame wants you to believe that, yes, I loved you. I had this connection with you. I felt something I've never felt before. I'm going to be totally honest here because I'm always honest in my podcast. For me, that was the biggest question I wanted to know. For me, it was all the time I was wondering, did I imagine this? Did I imagine this connection? Did he feel any of this, what I felt when we first met? Am I crazy in my head? What was this thing? Maybe I just made it all up. Maybe it was just a little like fling or something like this. But why? I simply can't get out of my mind. Why he's keep on coming back to me if it was just a little fling. Voila, here is exactly me. I was asking these questions all the time. Now I'm about to tell you, and here is a little bit the steps will go now mix and match, because it's just a journey which I'm trying to explain you. The moment I couldn't no longer sleep for the fact that, or I mean, I was universe was telling me all the time, you need to start a podcast, you need to share the story, you need to tell to others, you need to help them, you need to guide them, you need to help them to wake up and get there faster. Or, like, I don't like the word faster. I'd like to have the more of the idea, like, maybe less painfully, or more of the fact that you starting to realize the connection. Because faster, slower, I mean, we need to trust the process. We need to trust the divine timing as well. So it's not only that you do everything like by the textbook and then nothing happens because there is no trust. But anyways, I'm telling you, there's so much to tell. So it's going to be a little bit. When I started my podcast, I completely actually forgot about the fact that I wanted these answers. I completely, like, I started the podcast and I was like, okay, I'm fine if, I don't know, 10 people will listen to it. Maybe it will help them. Maybe it will connect with them. Maybe there is something more. And right after that, I would say, I don't remember exactly, but maybe 10, 15 days later, or maybe 3 weeks later, something like that, because I don't have my phone right now to double check. I started my podcast, started sharing, feeling really like in my element and feeling that I'm owning my truth. I'm owning the fact that, yes, I met my twin flame. Yes, it actually happened to me. And it was the most difficult thing so far I've gone through. And then guess what happened? My twin flame told me everything. Everything about our connection, everything that he felt, everything that happened to him, every single thing. And it was like one on one. And I was reading this and I was just sitting and reading and sitting and reading. And I was like, I can't believe that. I can't believe he's telling me every single question I have been struggling in my head, struggling to realize. And now the moment I'm no longer searching for that, I just know it because I was able to express it out through podcast. I was able to connect and I was able to tell. He just told me everything. Everything. He told me, it's a little bit in French, but it was like this, that I was so attached to you, but it felt like an impossible love. And he said, like, I felt that the connection, it was just incroyable. And I was like, what the heck? For a year, I was thinking that maybe it was just me. Maybe I made it up. Maybe I don't know what it was. And the moment I was starting to do what the universe asked me to do, the moment I was owning the truth that yes, I am part of Twin Flame. I am the Twin Flame. He showed back and he told me everything I wanted to know. Every single thing. Why he didn't tell before? Because I was not ready to receive it. I would have still questioned it. But by that time, I was sitting and I was like, wow. And a funny fact with this as well is that now if I reflect back to it, I remember actually getting these answers through telepathy. I was really getting the same answers through telepathy. And I was just thinking like, well, it's not true. I'm just making it up. It's my mind who wants this kind of answers. It's not me. It's not true. Until it was true. Until I own my truth that, well, we don't have a proof, but there are twin flames out there. It happens to have that our soul split and it lives in two different bodies. But the moment we met, I've never felt something like this in my life. And believe me, I am the one who is meeting so many people. I mean, I can guess, I think a weekly, I meet about 30 to 40 people, different backgrounds, different things. And I having even conversations and I've never, ever felt something like that. Like this whole thing is like a crazy movie. So that was, we're going to lead us to the next thing. That why I spoke about the fear. Every single fear you have that is holding you back, what you're supposed to do, or you're supposed to say, or you're supposed to start, has to go out of you and you need to start doing what you're supposed to do. And here's another proof again. The moment you become honest with yourself, and you start, how do I say, you start owning your truth that, okay, I met my twin flame. I'm not saying you should explain that you are a twin flame to someone who hasn't been on this journey. No, you don't have to. But you have to accept it for yourself that I'm no longer the same person. No matter how hard you're trying to hold on to, you're no longer the same person. Your twin flame has changed your life forever. And you are not going back where you who you were. It's as simple as that. Now I'm just going to also want to say certain things. And I know a lot of men are doing it. Because maybe women as well. Women are maybe differently, but men. If you have come across with your twin flame, and you're financially supporting your twin flame and you're trying to fix your twin flame's life with the finances, please stop doing it. Why? Because if it's a real twin flame journey, if it's a real twin flame connection, it's not you who is going to save their financial situation. It's not you who is going to buy their love or keep their love because you are not believing in yourself 100%. I'm not saying that men shouldn't take care of the women. I'm not saying that at all. What I'm saying is that I see a lot of vulnerable men out there who are trying to fix their twin flames by supporting them with money, by trying to fix their finances. Please take a step back and go within to realize why you're so afraid that this woman will not love you when you don't have the money. And I'm also about to say to you, universe will give you so much more money, wealth, and everything when you align with your purpose and your line of understanding that you are the one who attracts, not the one who is needy and needs to keep everything. So for the men who are listening, or also the women who are doing it, you don't need to buy anybody's love and you don't need to financially support anybody. I'm not saying that you shouldn't take care of it when you are together, and this is a completely different story. What I'm saying is, when you are trying to fix things with the money, that means you are afraid of losing someone, and the money is the one that is helping you to stay together. So please let go of that habit as soon as you can and face yourself that you deserve the best. You deserve the best love, you deserve the best care, and you deserve everything. I'm also saying this, well, we'll keep for the next time, but often our divine masculines are running for the fact that they are feeling that they cannot financially support us or take care of us or provide us the life we need. And this just shows that there is a low self-worth. And also it goes the other way around. If our twin flame stays around and you are financially supporting them and you are trying to fix their life, that again shows low self-worth and low self-responsibility. These are low vibrational energies and they will never come together into the same level until we let go of it. And so this is a longer topic actually, because I've heard so many stories where men are literally playing and when they have met their twin flame and then the twin flame has vanished or something like this, and they are still in there, they have this so low self-worth energy, and I would like you to change that. Again, if you need any help, if you need any kind of guidance to unblock that energy, to go within, that is possible to do. Money is important. Money helps to do things. But just please remember that you will have a lot more money, a lot more attraction when you stop being in a fear state. And then, like I said, you start doing what you're supposed to do. For me, it was starting the podcast. For me, it was starting to connect the community. For me, it was to help others with my channeling, with my energy. I will speak about the channeling at the end of the podcast a little bit more, what it means and what it helps. Because I've been speaking a lot about how you shouldn't focus on your twin flame and you should be focusing on yourself. But there are situations where we need channeling. So I'm going to talk about that at the end. And then there are, I would say, three other steps. One thing is you start trusting the universe. You start trusting that whatever universe is throwing at you, whatever you're supposed to do, you start doing it. Not sitting at home and wondering, what will happen if I do this? What will happen if I go there? What will happen if I should do this? No, you do what you're supposed to do. Should you reach out to your twin flame and say to the twin flame? It's again depending on the situation. There is no exactly black and white situation. I've now spoken to many who have told me that they reached out to their twin flame and they literally said, listen, look up for the twin flames. We must be the twin flames. Was that helpful or not? These things will be now told in divine timing. So that's something that is another thing you have to trust. When you do every single step I just told you, and then you surrender into divine timing by saying, I believe that it will happen when it's supposed to happen. I'm not the one who is going to manipulate the time and space for now and everything, because there is a reason. There is a reason why your twin flame hasn't come back to you. I can tell you, me and my twin flame, we used to live in the same city, really close to each other, and we could never meet, never ever, even though we were working under the same company. We could never meet, but prior we were meeting all the time, like very simply, easily. But then it couldn't happen no longer. Explain me this. And then on top of that, me, who was obsessed about my twin flame, packed my stuff and moved kilometers away from my twin flame. And then all of a sudden there was a union. Now you'll be wondering, but you're not with your twin flame. Yes, I'm not with my twin flame, but I'm in a union with my higher self. I'm in touch with my twin flame every day, and I see this connection way, way more than I saw this before. It's harder for him now. It's actually much harder on him, but I'm here to support. I'm here the same way like I'm supporting you. Of course, there are some other simple things that you have to schedule into your daily routine, such as meditation, breath work. Breath work doesn't have to be daily, but let's say in every 2 weeks, in every once a week, something like that. Sound healing if you can. If you can go to the retreat, I'm planning to do one of the twin flame retreat. So hopefully this will happen soon and you can join and you can see how it will shift your energy, because I'm all about shifting the energy. And I have here just, it was the whole blueprint of what you're supposed to do and how to do. I will try to put the workbook out there that you can do that on your own. I put the masterclass out there where it is much longer, but then you can watch it anytime and just do the same exercise. It will come with a breath work, with a sound healing, and it will come all of that. So there will be a lot that is coming. So please like, subscribe, and stay tuned, because for you, it will be very, very helpful, and it will help you to become your higher self. I also want to say that there is this another thing which I'm getting, and we're going to the channeling now. What means channeling and why I'm offering the channeling? Channeling is the energy channeling. You and your twin flame are sharing the same energy blueprint. So if I speak to you, I can connect with your twin flame. I can connect with their energy. I can connect with what they're going through, what is happening, what are their fears, why they haven't reached out to you, and what is happening currently energetically in their life. So that's why when we are having energy channeling, it's a bit different than consultation call, because we are starting to tap into the energy by step, feeling the numbers, feeling the signs. And I'm going into the meditative state where I'm like, okay, I'm getting this answer, this, and this. Now, the question is, will the channeling help force your twin flame to wake up? No. No. And one more time, no. The more you're trying to wake up your twin flame, like you're forcing that, wake up, you know, it's your time, I am already awakened, why you're not waking up, what is your problem? Again, we are coming back to the second or third point, where it's about them, not about you. When you are in balance and you know that your twin flame is about to wake up, because you can feel it, For me, it was the same thing. All of a sudden, I started feeling really exhausted and tired. And I was like, that's something I haven't felt before. And there were a lot of emotions. And then guess what? My twin flame was starting to wake up. And that was not so pleasant. And it was something I was like, wow, that's intense. But now I can recognize that. So I know it sounds so crazy. Every time when I say it out, it sounds so crazy to my head. Is that we are sharing the same energy. But when we are trying to force somebody to wake up, we are actually pulling them even further away from it. Why? Think of yourself when somebody forces you to do something you don't want to do. Let's say even as a child, somebody said to you, you need to go to school, but you didn't want to go to school. And you need to be and learning this and you didn't want to learn this. What did you do? You learned that with the like anger and you were like, I don't want to do this, but okay, I'll do this. I'll be this. I'll do that. Well, never mind. I'll just do it. And here what happens when we force our twin flames, the more they become distanced because this energy is so intense for them. So for them, it's like, I don't want to feel this way. I don't want to be in this. Why I have to feel this way? This is ridiculous. Why did I even start to feel this way? Can it go out of my head? Can I just live my life normally? I don't want to do this. So now you'd be asking me, so what are the ways of letting them to wake up? It's the trust. You give them every day a trust through your own energy that it's okay. You are no longer the same person, but it's okay. I know we have a strong connection. I know we are connected. I know you love me. I know I love you. You are me. I feel you. I know who you are. And I know that you're coming back to me when the time is right. And so far, I'll be serving the world in the highest good I can. But why we should do the energy channeling, when we talk about the energy channeling, which is on my website, you can book the call. Why you should do that? One of the things is that sometimes we get very confused. We feel their energy, if we feel a lot of it's happening, and we are like in between, like you feel like you're doing a lot of work on yourself, you're letting go, you are like getting into the balance, and then it comes in and you just don't understand what are you getting. Like there's so much energy coming and it's so strong and weird things are happening and you just can't get the answers. Then it's better to do energy channeling and feel, okay, what is the energy that is coming through you that I can feel and I can see and I can connect with. And like this, we start unblocking it. And it will become more, it will become easier for your twin flame and for you. So that's why energy channeling is very powerful, as there is no longer, like we are starting to unblock the things, but not unblocking things with a force, with a kindness, with the understanding, okay, he has to go through this, he will go, once he goes through it, he will feel much better. So that was a lot for today. I don't know if you got the answers from here, if that helped you, but I hope it did. I'm just going to go through a couple of things such as Patreon. Like I spoke about before on our Patreon, you can now listen to the latest call that was about Twin Flames and Ayahuasca and the Divine Masculine Energy. How I met a beautiful woman who was divine masculine in prior, now is divine feminine, actually both. I mean, she's in balance. And she shares her experience of why did she run, and everybody in a group call were asking questions, trying to figure it out, and so on. If you wish to hear that, join the Patreon, the link is in bio, and you can list that. Your Patreon is for first 7 days for free. You have a free trial. You can see if you're able to support and so on. I mean, your support means a lot to me because that means I can devote so much more time of putting out the content, sharing it, and also start putting out the exclusive content, because it's definitely that certain things cannot be shared publicly. So there's going to be more exclusive content and also the group call. So if you're my Patreon, you have twice a month a chance to join the group call. This Sunday, we will be meeting again on the 10th of September. And it will be at 12 o'clock New York time, 6 o'clock Central European time. And it will be via Zoom. Everybody can talk, everybody can share, everybody can ask questions. This time we're going to exactly talk about these steps. The fear. Fear of why I'm not doing what I'm supposed to do that will help me to get closer to my twin flame. So this is something we're going to discuss over there. Feel free to join. The link is in bio. Your support means a lot. And if you can support, it's great. Another thing is that every month I choose one lucky winner for a one free consultation call. So if you are my Patreon, you will get. Last time we had, there is a wheel which I'm going to spin. You can see it live, who is going to win it. And then we schedule a call for it. Last time winner call is about to come up as well. And then, like I said about it, I'm really working hard right now of putting out a 30 days course. Like it's 30 days every day where you will have step by step things that will start to happen to you in order to become union with your twin flame. And this masterclass will be available. Discount the price for Patreons and also all the subscribers. This is something I know that will shift your energy if you do that, and you'll have it access all the time whenever you feel. Within the 30 days, you will have a completely different life. But that's what I'm working on. So just make sure to subscribe for the email list, subscribe for the channels. And then I have another huge thing to say. This is so big for me that I don't even know how to put into the words. Apart from all the YouTube subscribers, apart from everything, like, I mean, you are amazing. I'm going to say it one more time. I really thought that I'm going to have 10 listens, and that's good. That was something I was aiming for, that if I help 10 people, my job is done here. I reached, or the Twin Flame Awakening podcast reached over 10,000 listens within the short period of time. Over 10,000 listens. I remember in August, I looked, I was 9,000 something, and I said, it'd be great if end of the month I will reach 10,000. It'd be nice thing to celebrate. And I reached there before end of the month. And I just want to say to all of you who are listening, and it's the same on YouTube, I have over 100,000 views. You are the best. You are the reason I am getting up every day and putting out the content and I would like to connect. You are the reason that I feel I am serving my purpose in life. So thank you so much. Thank you for each like. Thank you for each comment, and thank you for each listen, support, view. It means so much to me. So that's what I wanted to say. So I hope you enjoyed today's episode, and I hope to see you soon here. Now we should go back to the regular flow. And so a lot of content is on its way. Lots of love and light. You are the best.